Ontology and epistemology, what on earth do they mean? How are they relevant to your research? Well, stay tuned because I'm going to tell you. I'm Dr. Elizabeth Yardley, and I've been supporting master's degree and doctoral students for the last 20 years. Now, every student that I've supported, there has been a stage where they've written up their methods chapter, or they've written up a draft of their methods chapter. They've sent it through to me to have a look at. And one of the questions that I've gone back to them with has been, what about your ontology and your epistemology? Now they look at me like, ew, why would you say those words to me? Why would you do this to me? And that's because when people have encountered those words before, ontology and epistemology, they've often not been explained very well. They've often been explained in quite abstract terms, in terms that are quite detached from the actual project that the student's doing. So this video is my attempt to demystify them. However, before we get onto that, if you are currently trying to get your head around the whole ontology and epistemology thing, you might find this helpful. It's my ontology and epistemology one-page cheat sheet. It summarises the key points around the main ontological and epistemological positions. So go and check it out. It's completely free. The link is in the description. Okay, so let's deal with ontology first. Ontology is about the what question. What am I looking at? What am I seeing? What's in front of me? Essentially, it's about how you perceive the social world that you're studying. Because our perspective on the social world we're studying has an impact on the type of research that we then do within it. We need to figure out where our view of the social world sits in relation to other people's view of the social world. And you can start to get your head around the main ontological positions by thinking about the social world as either a hotel or a home. Is the social world like a hotel where we are just temporary guests? We're not making any massive changes to it. We are essentially just passing through. The hotel stands independently, unaffected by our presence. It is essentially a concrete reality. This aligns with a realist position on ontology, which essentially sees the world as stable, as objective, of something that exists independently of us. At the other end of the spectrum, we might think about the social world like a home. We actively shape a home. We decorate it. We influence it. We change it. We impact upon it in quite a profound way. It's not just a concrete structure. It is a home that is uniquely crafted by us. It's full of personal touches and it is saturated with emotion, especially when someone in that home forgets to put the bins out. This reflects a social constructivist viewpoint. Social constructivists see the social world as dynamic, as something that is constantly evolving. The social world isn't seen as a fixed entity. It's more like a malleable substance that's being created and recreated by the people that inhabit it. Multiple realities coexist, shaped by personal feelings and interpretations and biases. So, a very brief recap on ontology. Ontology is about the what question. What do we see when we look at the social world? Do we take a realist stance when we see a fixed and largely unchangeable entity that exists independently of us? Or do we take a social constructivist stance when we see a flexible, ever-evolving social world that is changing in response to the people that inhabit it? Now let's delve into the realm of epistemology. Epistemology is about the how question. So how do we go about making sense of this social world? Ontology helps us figure out what we're actually looking at. Epistemology gives us a frame of reference to begin understanding it, to begin studying it, to begin generating knowledge about it. Once again, we discover two ends of the spectrum here. At the one end are positivists, who seek to explain things and identify the causes. Positivists take an approach to understanding the social world, which is quite reminiscent of the approaches of the natural sciences to studying the natural world, so biology, chemistry, physics. And you tend to find that some of the questions that positivists ask are quite reminiscent of the questions that you see in the natural sciences. So, for example, what causes people to behave the way they do? What factors influence their behaviour? Their research mirrors the deductive nature of the scientific method. So that essentially means that they test existing theories that were developed by their predecessors. At the other end of the spectrum, we encounter the interpretivists, and their focus is on understanding things and identifying the meanings. They argue that the subject matter of the natural sciences is completely different from the subject matter of the social sciences. They argue that humans, with their distinctiveness and their individuality, they infuse meaning into their actions. People are not mere objects that can be studied objectively because Their behaviour is laden with meaning and with significance. So the kind of questions that the interpretivists ask are quite different from the kind of questions that positivists ask. So they ask questions like, how do people make sense of their actions? And what do these actions mean to them and to others? Their research takes an inductive approach. So rather than testing existing theories, like the positivists do in their deductive approach, the interpretivists generate new theory from the observations that they make of the social world. So in a nutshell, epistemology prompts us to consider. Are we observers seeking to explain things and identify the causes, maintaining quite a detached and objective stance? If so, we are positivists. Are we participants seeking to understand things and identify the meanings whilst acknowledging our role within the creation of meaning? That is an interpretivist stance. So to recap, ontology and epistemology really are as simple as the what question and the how question. Ontology is the what question. When you look at the social world, what do you see? Epistemology is the how question. How do you then go about studying that social world? Ontology, what am I looking at? Epistemology, how do I go about studying it? I hope you found all of this helpful. Don't forget to go and download your ontology and epistemology free cheat sheets, and I'll be back here very soon with another video on navigating the messy and the magical of PhD life. I'll see you then.